It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Corinthians 13:13. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Amazing job. Their relationship epitomizes the adage that iron sharpens iron, as they will continue to challenge and uplift each other to new heights. I could certainly have read from the passage. However, I reflected a while. And so I asked Aaron, why this passage? And what does it mean to you? I loved his answer, as it held a deeper significance and more personal connection. This is what he said, and I quote, "What this passage means to me is that the true divine source, God, not only gives us with life, but gives us with the one person we're destined to share a life into eternity with." What resonated with me mostly was that man asked of his equal and the womb of man, "Woman, was Aaron to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold, to love, honor, and cherish, in sickness as well as in health, forsaking all others from this day forward?"
I do.
Ow!
"Do you, Aaron, take Chardae to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, to love, honor, and cherish, in sickness as well as in health, forsaking all others from this day forward?"
I do. Yes, I accept all terms.
May God's blessing shower upon both of you, guide guiding your journey together. Now, with the authority given to me by American Marriage Ministry and the state of California, I pronounce you husband and wife.
The mother of the bride. So how many more kids you got to get married off,
right? Six more. Oh, six.
I gotta go.
Who's next? Who's next in the bunch? Who's getting married next?
We don't even know.
I got the baby. I need it right now.
Still in here?
Melina, you lost your voice?
Beautiful bride.
I'm wearing that.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
This is it.
That's it.